Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our series in which what we do, we daily discuss important articles that appear in your Indian Express newspaper. So today is 30 October, you might be aware of the date, so we will be discussing important articles that have appeared in today's newspaper. So before starting, please consider this worldly wise, which is very beautiful. So here George Bernard Shaw had once said that the biggest or the single biggest problem in communication is the illusion that it has taken place. So we think that we have communicated our concerns or our viewpoint to others, but in fact if the communication is proper, then obviously differences would not arise. But this illusion that communication has taken place, this led to differences. So let's discuss about first article, that is Journey to a Beginning. So this article is written by the state of Punjab's chief minister, that is Amrinder Singh. So this is in context of Kartarpur corridor. So you might be aware of the fact, friends, that Kartarpur corridor has recently been it will be soon operationalized, in which the place that is the Kartarpur Sahib that is in Pakistan and Gurdwara Darbar Sahib there will be opened to opened as a visa free access by Pakistan to the pilgrims that will go there. So in this context, the author has written this article. So he highlights the importance of this site. So Kartarpur Sahib is basically it is a town whose foundation was laid down by Guru Nanak Dev Ji, that is the first gurus of Sikhs, and he died there in 1539. So this author talks about his personal as well as his spiritual connect with the city. So in this context, what the main crux of the article is, because I will not be going into that detail, so that I will be leaving on you people, so that you people can read it on your own, because ultimately your own reading helps you in recalling the facts or we can say information that you learn. So the brief idea is that though there are major differences that are there between India and Pakistan, especially in this year with the beginning of Pulwama attack, and then after Balakot strikes and other such incidents like abrogation of Article 370 on 5 August by the government of India. But then this author says that this historic Kartarpur corridor, where the Gurdwara Darbar Sahib is there, so the opening of it is a kind of a bridge that will and it is a bridge of faith that will bridge the differences between the two countries. So in this context, author highlights that it is not just the achievement of India but also of Pakistan that against all odds this agenda of Kartarpur Sahib corridor was pursued, and this entire negative atmosphere was kept aside by both the countries in operationalizing this corridor. So, but then author says that in this context, it must be seen as a symbol of peace, and it must also be seen as a testimony to the fact that despite differences, both the countries, if they are willing to do away with their differences, they can do away with them. But then here author says that the major role here is obviously of Pakistan, because Pakistan has the responsibility to ensure that the cross-border terrorism that is being perpetrated against India from Pakistani soil, it is controlled, because ultimately it is the Pakistan's responsibility. So things can turn normal, but then the major role can be played by Pakistan by ensuring that cross-border terrorism is arrested, and so that all also the climate of mistrust that and fear that that is there, it can be bridged, and a climate of mutual understanding develops. So in this context, author highlights that this must be a Kartarpur Sahib corridor must be seen as a common aspiration and a common aspiration of India and Pakistan people for a common future. So other thing author says that the Pakistan must waive that $20 fee that is imposed on pilgrims visiting the revered Gurdwara. So author says that it would do well if Pakistan respect the sentiments of India's people. But then also author highlights that our differences have since independence our differences have grown too much. But then ultimately if we are willing to bring peace, then we will be able to do so. And in this context, Kartarpur Sahib can prove to be a beginning and to bridge that mistrust and hatred that is there among two countries. So in the end, author concludes that it is as of now in the given circumstances that are prevailing, the more responsibility is of Pakistan than of India, because basically cross-border terrorism is the major issue that India faces almost from two, three decades from Pakistan, from the side of Pakistan. So this is about your first article. So friends, I will not be going into that details, because obviously if you are preparing for civil services, reading is must, and you must read in detail article on your own. So my purpose is only to give you a brief idea, because I suppose that you are a graduate student and you are not that much immature that you will not be able to understand once you are given proper or a brief understanding of the article or brief crux of the article. Then other is a visit, a diversion. So here author talks about the recent visit of the European Union parliamentarians. So you might be aware that recently some parliamentarians, the delegation of parliamentarians is visiting Kashmir, and they are of European Union. And then in this context, author says that this visit is not official, and also most of the MPs belong to the right wing, which is not currently in power in European Union. So obviously this is not an official delegation. So also in this context, author highlights that especially when Indian political leaders are not allowed to visit Delhi, and the political leaders of Kashmir are kept under detention for 3 months from as of now, then certainly this visit doesn't have any major impact, because it might be seen as just a kind of, we can say, response to the allegation of US that foreign persons are not allowed to visit Kashmir. So then problematic is that so obviously the biggest problematic nature of this delegation is that it is not an official delegation. So all the parliamentarians have come here in their personal capacity. So it would can also be then certainly said that these right wing political party parliamentarians, they basically sometimes they have admired Nazism or and also they have become sometimes anti-immigration, or their views are dominated by Islamophobia. So in this context, the issue is the idea basically is to impress upon the world that government is not blocking foreign dignitaries from visiting Kashmir. So as was they pointed out at the US Congress hearing. But then author says that at the same time when these MPs made the visit, the United Nations asked the Indian government to restore the rights of the Kashmiris that have been detained or the general Kashmiri population. So here in government here the as impression comes, so that government is trying to legitimize its move and trying to refute that allegation that that government is not allowing the foreign dignitaries to visit Kashmir. So in this context, author says that certificates from these handpicked delegation will do nothing to paper over the fact that that the government has pushed into through its decision by imposing communications blockade, and now it has been slow to lift the curbs and restrictions on the right of the people to free speech and freedom of association. So obviously as of now all the leaders are detained, and then all the political leaders of the mainstream political parties are detained event, and then other issues like communication blockade is there. So the fact of the thing that how the decision was taken is again troublesome in that context, or such a delegation will not have that much impact. So this is basically highlighted by author. So now let's move on to the next article. Next is no stress leave. So this is in context of the telecom sector, that is very we can say facing very we can very stormy conditions, very stormy weather, because you might be aware of the fact that telecom sector companies are incurring huge losses. So in this context, particularly relevant is the decision of the Supreme Court, which was announced last week on Thursday, that held the government's viewpoint about the tussle that was going on between telecom companies and government. So the issue was of aggregate this adjusted gross revenue. So what the telecom companies were saying, they were saying that the earning or revenue from non core activities, they don't form a part of adjusted gross revenue. But now Supreme Court has held that they do form the part of adjusted gross revenue. So thus they will be under the we can say jurisdiction of the government, so that government can impose taxes on such revenue. So in this context, author highlights that this would mean that some estimates have said that this would incur a cost of 1.3 lakh crore to telecom companies. Then the other thing is that the government has announced the revival plan by merging BSNL and MTNL. So in this context, author says that when these are loss making public companies, and they and in present scenario when there is so much stress in telecom companies, these two measures may not prove sustainable, because obviously government may look at the thing that that it will get 1.3 lakh crore in the form of revenue, and it will offset the decline in tax revenue of the government. But then this is not a long-term vision, because ultimately when telecom companies are facing such stormy conditions, such hardline approach will not work. And again, obviously when BSNL and MTNL are two loss-making public entities, and then reviving them at the cost of taxpayer, and also supporting them at the cost of by providing them such terms and conditions, by providing them favorable terms and conditions, that may result in market distortion. Because these public entities may get better conditions to operate than their private counterparts. So in this context, author says that particularly this is more concerning when 5G auctions are soon to be auctioned. So obviously if the revenues of the companies are falling, so how they can borrow stake in 5G auctions? So that would be problematic. So this must be looked into. So the simple thing the author wants to highlight is that this decision of the Supreme Court, that is of adjusted gross revenue, and then the decision of the government to merge BSNL and MTNL, they are poorly timed. So this is basically the main thing about this article. Next article is the running air marshals. We will not be discussing this article. This is particularly concerned with the particular individual, so UPSC doesn't ask such questions. And then other thing is that in a plastic world, so this is a very important article. So this is also the last article that we will be discussing, because here again this is your article associated with the personality. So here author highlights to the two authors are there, that is Ishar Judge Aluwalia and Almitra Patel. So the article very beautifully highlights the challenge that is there in the context of the unabated use of plastic that is there in our daily life. So here authors talk about not just about the single use plastics, but also the other plastic waste that is generated. So you might be aware of the fact that on 15 August 2019, Prime Minister made the announcement that India would eliminate single use plastics by 2022. So then other announcement again came when there was Gandhi Jayanti. So such author highlights that this is the single-use plastics is a significant problem, because single-use plastics are not just the alone thing, but then they form a large part of entire plastic waste. So as per the study estimates, that is by a study by FICCI, so it estimate that 43% of India's plastics are used in packaging, and much of it is single-use plastic. So this is the main thing. So you might not be knowing about single-use plastics. So single-use plastic is a type of plastic in which is used only once. For example, if you buy a Lay's packet or chips packet, then you eat the chips or Lay's and then throw away the packaging material. Or you suppose buy a online product and it is shipped to your home address, and then you open up it and the packaging material you just throw away. So that is a category of single-use plastic. So this is significant because the 43% of as the study says that 43% of the plastic that is used in India is basically used for packaging. So obviously the single-use plastics form a big part of it. So then other thing is that but then single-use plastic is not only one thing. It is a truly massive challenge, and managing single-use plastic is part of it. But then it is also about management of all kinds of plastic waste. Because ultimately it is good if we start with single-use plastics, as is announced by the Prime Minister. So there is a kind of growing volume of plastic that is being generated. So a significant amount of it is being contributed by single-use plastics. So why there is so much plastic in today's world? Because when it was first invented, it was held that or not only held, it was experienced that it is durable, it is flexible, as well as it is light and it is very cheap. So flexibility is that and durability is that it is available in different sizes, and also it is durable. It is not we can say short lasting, and then other thing is that it is very light. So in this context, plastics became popular. So plastic is not just used in packaging, but also then your airplanes, computers, cars, trucks, all such kind of things, and other vehicles, or apart from it, refrigerators, air conditioners for furnitures, or casings for electric wires, all use plastics. So plastic has become a kind of a way of life. But then the problem is basically about plastics is that it doesn't decompose automatically, because it is non biodegradable. It remains there in your environment for thousands of years. So that is a major problem, because it becomes difficult to then manage the waste that is generated by this plastic. So as of now, author highlights that currently more than 20 states have one kind of ban on the plastic, that is one or more kind of ban on plastic, that is a complete or partial ban. But then states like states have examples have been given. For example, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, and Himachal Pradesh have opted for complete bans, while there are some states, for example Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, Odisha, they have tried partial bans. But such bans have not been effective because of the very strengths of the plastic that it provides, the plus points that it provides, that is the durability, flexibility, and lightweight, and being cheap. So obviously this plastic carry bags pose a special kind of problem. So other thing is that although they are strong, lightweight, and useful, and can be saved, cleaned and reused many times, but this is not done because they are very cheap. So and they are obviously, due to they being cheap, they are not valued. So they become effectively in nutshell, they also become single use plastic. So other thing here also highlights that there is for example the authors give the example of Ireland, in which the author says that there must be a kind of compulsory charge by retail stores on the carry bags that are provided to the customer. So this type of experiment has proved to to be very effective. And the example here cited is of Ireland, in which when in the bill the amount of the carry bag was added, there was a reduction in 95 we can say the 95% of the reduction of in demand was there. So for such carry bags, so because shoppers, what they did, they started bringing their own reusable grocery bags. So in nutshell, what it leads to reduction in use of such plastics, which have the potential to become single use plastics, because there is a nominal fee for it. So rather than banning such kind of interventions can help. But then also author highlights about the plastic waste management rules 2016 that provided in the rule number 15 that there must be a pricing for of carry bags, that carry bags must be charged. So the required vendors, they were required to register and pay an annual fee to the urban local bodies. But then lobbying that was done by the plastic producers led to the removal of this clause, rule number 15, that is there in plastic waste management rules. So, and this thing author says that this was done without any public debate, which is mandatory. And then other thing is that plastic producers have in India, the plastic producers have been advocating thicker and thicker micron sizes for carry bags. But then when there is a ban on carry bags, also there is a increase in use of non-woven polypropylene, so which feels like cloth and also printed like to look like cloth. But then it is also more dangerous because the fine fibers that result after the wear and tear, they rub off and enter the global waters as microplastics. So when the other thing is that all these things are posing major challenges. For example, in Pacific Ocean, a large we can say garbage patch is floating, and it is estimated that it is of the size of Texas or more. And also the plastic is being found in the marine life, and then it is also affecting marine life and also the life over the earth. For example, it leads to flooding, and also sometimes the animals that roam around, the roaming livestock, they basically feed on these plastic carry bags, because people usually they throw away the waste food in them, and in search of food, these roaming livestock end up eating them, and eventually they enter their stomachs, and they are ultimately it results in death. So then also plastic waste is eventually carried by rain, streams and rivers into the oceans. So this is also a major concern. But then also other thing is that we need to build a kind of awareness among the customers, because that will only work. Because if there is people are not aware, then obviously there will not be minimization of its use. So when people are made aware, when the consumers are made aware about the ill effects of it, obviously there can be a behavioral change among the people to minimize their use. So for example, at airports we can use other alternatives. But then there are also different type of examples that are given. So here it must be kept in mind that there must be kind of, we can say, for example, in parties there is a practice of throwing away plastics, which must be ended, and these parties should be replaced with washable, reusable tableware. So but then single-use plastics can also potentially be converted into thermomechanical recycling into plastic granules, which can be blended with other plastic products. For example, for irrigation, for making irrigation piping for agriculture. But the thing is that the issue with such type of thermomechanical, we can say, recycling, thermomechanical conversion. The thing is that there are many, many, many packaging firms that do packaging in multi-layers. So plastic that is employed is multi-layered. So obviously, if the in which different types of plastics, different types of polymers are used, and they all have different melting points. So due to which thermomechanical recycling also doesn't take place. For example, multi-layer flexible packaging is used for chips and other snacks, and it cannot be made into granules because it contains layers of plastic with different melting points. So plastic waste management rules of 2016 highlight that in such a context there is a responsibility of extended producer there is a rule called extended producer responsibility or manufacturer responsibility, in which the manufacturer is ultimately responsible for taking back this plastic waste that is being generated due to their production, and or they must give appropriate fee to the government so that waste management can take place, so that the municipalities or local bodies can do effective waste management of their entire waste that is generated. But there is the main thing is that there is little compliance, because compliance is not taking place. Then other thing is that also that author highlights that it is believed in India that India has a large network of informal waste collectors, due to which recycling in India is quite good. But then yes, it is a fact, but other side of the coin is also that our consumption pattern is increasing, our consumption demand is increasing, due to which we are generating more waste than ever. So this waste is generated at a pace at which it is not recycled. So obviously it is ultimately leading to net increase in the waste in our environment. So here author highlights that there are different innovative alternatives that can be adopted, and also there are some recycling choices that have been given. For example, the value of the roads or the endurance or we can say strength of the roads that are built using plastic material has been proved. But then here also the corruption takes its toll, because obviously contractors, they do not want to make enduring roads, because that would result in fewer contracts for building and rebuilding poor quality roads that are being built by them currently. So there are also various other ideas that have been given. So author in the end concludes that such innovative ideas must be adopted, and there must also be a fundamental change in the mindset so that the single-use plastic can be eliminated. Because single-use plastic is the worst form of plastic that affects our environment, or that pollutes our marine ecosystem and then air biosphere completely, our biosphere, in a very adverse manner. So there must be kind of, we can say, behavioral change, so that there must be minimum use of single-use plastic. And also we must acknowledge the fact that plastics do have their strengths, for example of durability, flexibility, and then being cheap. But then in this context we must accept that it has advantages, and it will be used continuously. But then we must work on recycling in this context. So there must be more recycling, more reduction in their usage. And if there can't be reduction, then there must be recycling. Proper recycling must take place. For example, proper waste management, plastic waste management must take place. That may be under that extended producer responsibility or manufacturer responsibility, and through various other innovative interventions. So friends, this is all about today's discussion about Indian Express important articles. So if you like this discussion, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So obviously 28 minutes have passed. Why I have not gone into the details, because that is not my business. Reading is very much important for civil services preparation, and if you want to get a proper idea, you can read the article. So this is all about friends today's video. And also friends, we also have a Telegram channel on which we have more than 14,000 subscribers that are following us and are in touch with us, and are able to access various sources that we are sharing for the purpose of civil services preparation. So if you want to be part of those 14,000 students, then do ensure that you check our description box, because the link of our Telegram channel is given in the description box. So you can use that link to join our Telegram channel and and you can remain in touch with us through that telegram channel. So this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead.